So, good morning to all. Today we are going to start again the block diagram reduction technique, some more things are related to it. So let us start. So if there is any problem up to so far what we have covered, please write in the comment box, chat box, okay, and we can take it. So we have covered so far that what a transfer function is, what how the transfer function is represented by blocks. Then we have considered the certain rules. The first rule was related to the blocks in cascade and parallel. Second rule was related to moving a summing point behind a block. Then the third rule was moving a summing point ahead of a block. The fourth rule was related to the pickoff point. Okay, again the same behind a block, and the fifth rule was moving a pickup point ahead of a block. Okay, then we have also considered some rules 6 and 7, how to eliminate a feedback loop, either positive or negative. Then it is g upon 1 minus plus gn. If it is a negative feedback, it will be plus, and if it is a positive feedback, it will be minus. And I've also told you that in control system, we will be mainly dealing with the negative feedback system. A special case has been taken where the feedback has been made equal to 1 and is for unity feedback system. Then we have also gone through an example. Okay, I have told you that ultimate objective is the summing point is on one side and the takeoff point is on the other side. So it is a practice who will govern you that how to solve the transfer function. Okay, let us take another example today to understand, to better understand the things. Okay. So this is the example I am taking. Now you can see that RS is the input, bias is the output. In between there is a feed forward and feedback blocks are there. Okay, so now you have to solve it. Okay, so first of all, is there any comment from your side? Okay, so the first step involved is the eliminating loop 1. Okay, so what it will do, this is the loop 1. Okay, very simple. You can see it is a negative feedback system is there, and you know the transfer function of such type of system is nothing but g upon 1 plus gh. Okay, so it's so it will be represented by a single block with transfer function equal to how much, I think. So it is clear or not, these things? Okay, this is nothing but a negative feedback system is there, a positive signal is coming, this is the feed forward transfer function and this is the feedback function. So what will be its transfer function from your point of view? It is g2 upon 1 plus g2 h. Very good. Okay, so you have come across this. Okay, so now comes the next step. So you will, I will replace it by a simple this. Okay, you can see now g2 upon 1 plus g2 h2. Clear? I think so. Now next, what is the moving a pickup point A behind block g2 upon 1 plus g2 h2. Now see this point A is there. This is what? This is the pickup point. Okay, now I have to move behind the block, means I have to put here, I have to move from A to B. Okay, so what happens if you remember? Then what happens, what will happen, give me in the chat box what will happen if I will move the pickup point, because you have to keep in mind pickup point is on all this output side, while the summing point used to be generally in the input side. So yeah, 1 upon g, very good, 1 upon g. So g is here, this whole one, g2 upon 1 plus g2 h2. So with the pickup point, a transfer function, a block will be added with transfer function equal to g2 upon 1 plus g2 h2. Okay, so how it will look like? See, will it look like this? Do you agree? Everybody agrees? Okay, yes, definitely. This is the rule which we have learned. So now the block diagram will look like this. Okay, so now what else you can do? once again, can you tell me what you can do? Just go through the circle which I have marked on the block, what we can do. Can anybody can tell me in which form these two blocks are connected? Yeah, firstly they are connected in cascade. Very good. Yes, very correct. H1 multiply by bracket 1 plus G2 S2 1 G2. Okay. Then feedback. Oh, many people are saying feedback. Please look towards the this. Is it feedback or it is something else? Yes. Sudhanshu is correct. Pranjay is correct. Yes, they are in parallel. See, mind it. It is also plus sign. Okay. This signal is also traversing in this side. The signal coming from SC is also traveling this side. Okay. Previously in feedback, mind it. In the feedback, there is a forward function is there and there is a opposite reverse signal is there. But here, both signal from this path and this path coming to the same point and their nodes are same. Node of this, so they are connected in parallel. And you know, if the blocks are connected in parallel, they will get, the resultant will be a single block consisting of addition of the transfer function of the two blocks. Okay, so how it will look like? So it is not a feedback loop, as committed mistake by many. It is not a feedback loop, it is a... So what will be the answer? The answer for the resultant of this will be H3 plus H1, 1 plus G2 H2 upon H2. Those who are confused with the H1, then let me tell you that H1 is in cascade with this block. So this block will become how much? H1, 1 plus G2 H2 upon G2. Okay. And this is your H3, which is in parallel with this. And when they are connected in parallel, they will get add up and you will get. So you can replace this hole by this block. Now you have left with this. Now tell me, students. Somebody has told very the G1 and G2 upon 1 plus G2 H2 are connected in cascade. Very good. They are connected in cascade, so they can be represented by a single block, and that block will be nothing but yes, that block will be. G1, G2 upon 1 plus G2, S2. And this is the block we have got by considering the parallel combination. Now look towards this. In which form it is looking? Feedback form. Very correct. It is looking in the feedback form. Yes. Now it is. And which feedback? Negative feedback. Correct answer, Jagdish Meghwal. Negative feedback. Very good. Yes, it is negative feedback. And we know the transfer function of a negative feedback is nothing but G upon 1 plus GH, where G is what? G1, G2 upon 1 plus G2. What is H? H is this hole. S3 plus H1 plus 1 plus G2 S2 upon S2. So we have to solve it mathematically using rule 6. And therefore, we will get the transfer function TS is equal to YS upon RS is nothing but G1, G2 upon 1 plus G2 S2 plus G1, G2 S3 plus G1 H1. Plus G1, G2, H1, H2. I think so. It is clear or not? Okay. Let us take another example. Okay. So the more you will solve the numerical, mind it. Okay. The more concept will get clear. This you have to keep in mind. Okay. And only if you are going through it, okay, then it is not going to solve your problem. You have to practice by your hand also. Okay. So very soon I will give you the assignment, some question also with answer also. Due to some busy schedule, I could not upload the things. Okay. So I will try my best. Okay. Very soon we will start it. So let us look toward this question. Okay. So by going through this question, okay, anything you can find out, what will be the solution? The first point. Okay. What will be the first point? The first point will be moving pickup point A behind block A. Okay. So this is the pickup point. As I've already told you, given you hint, that generally pickup point are being shifted towards, are being shifted towards, yes, write in the chat box, pickup point are generally shifted towards, yes, towards end. Yes, the proper word is output side, not end, output side, very good. It is, they are generally pickup point. This is the pickup point. They are shifted towards the output side, while the summing points are generally shifted towards the input side. So we will try to shift this point A towards this point. Okay. So what we will get? So behind the block, moving a pickup point behind the block means adding a transfer function G4, with adding a block with a transfer function 1 upon G4, mind it. So how it will look like? Let us. Okay, it will get, and both will get, since mind it, it was pickup point is there for H3 block also, for H2 is also, so both will get and transfer function, a block of transfer function 1 upon G4. I think so it is clear. If it is clear, then please write in the chat box. Those who could not get, then they can write their doubt in the chat box. Okay, so we will assume that it is 1 upon G4, and 1 upon G4 is clear to all. Okay, if there is no question is there. Now after this, how it will look like? Now see, when it will get shifted to this, then what happens? Please look towards. So now G3, G4 will be in cascade. Very good, very good. G3 and G4 will be in cascade. Yes, cascade. So your overall, it will be replaced by a single block with value G3, G4. And when G3 and G4 are in cascade, then what about this loop? What about this loop? Look towards my arrow consisting of H4 and block G3, G4. They are in which form? Yes, it is a feedback. But which feedback, Eva Sharma? Not parallel. Please, those who are writing parallel, it is not parallel. Why? Because see, this signal is moving forward while this moving is feedback form, backwards. So it is feedback. And which feedback? Negative feedback. Very correct. It is a negative feedback. Okay, so I am talking about this loop. Okay, G3, G4 will be connected in cascade. This will become H3 by 4. This will become H2 by 4. And this block will get solved. And you will get, again, if you could not get, then this block is in negative feedback. So its overall transfer function will be G3, G4 upon 1 plus G3, G4, H4. Okay, and I have shown like this. And moreover, the resultant of this negative feedback is in cascade with G2. Is in cascade with G2. So your overall transfer function will become by, it can be represented by a single block G2, G3, G4 upon 1 plus G3, G4, H4, like this. I think so it is clear. If not clear, if any doubt, please write down your doubt. Please write down your doubt in the chat box. It cannot be that out of the 23 participants. Okay. Everybody doubt is clear. No doubt. Those who have no doubt, they are writing no doubt, but I want people with some doubt. Okay, no problem. So now see, look towards this. The G2, G3, G4 upon 1 plus G3, G4 and H3 upon H4. In which form this is there? Can anybody tell me? Okay, what is this? This whole is in? In which form? Negative feedback. Again, this is negative feedback. And look towards this, side by side toward this also. This is also a negative feedback. Two negative feedbacks are there. So you can easily replace by a single transformation. Okay. And what will be the transfer function? You just see this and this one. Okay. So feedback. For the second one, what will be the answer? G2, G3, G4 upon 1 plus G3, G4, H4 plus G2, G3, H3. For the third one, okay, what will be there? Now see, third one is not feedback. It's mistake from my as well as from your side. Third one is not feedback. Is it feedback? Please tell me, is it feedback? I am saying this is not feedback, but is it feedback? Look towards the signal. Look towards the signal. Is it feedback? Says Bora say yes, it is feedback. Okay, Alicia is saying no. Okay. Pranjay is saying no, it is in parallel. Good. Akash one, it is in feedback. Okay. Tushar, Surendra Rajpur is no, no, no. Then what is in, if you are saying no, then in what form? No arrow, no. Yes, it is not in feedback, it is in parallel. In parallel also, they are subtracting. How? Please, those who could not understand, look towards the block diagram. Okay, see. This signal is traversing in this form. This feedback is there, but it is traveling. Similarly, this signal is also traveling in this form. It's negative feedback. But see, look towards over the feed forward signal. It is also towards the same direction as was the feedback. So they are not connected in feedback, but they are connected in parallel. So Shresh Bora, is it clear or not that they are connected in parallel or in feedback? Clear? Okay, so they are not feedback, they are connected in parallel, and whenever they are parallel, the transfer function gets added. Okay, but here negative sign is there, though, therefore we will take this H2 by G4 as plus and H1 as minus. So when you solve it, you will get, so ultimately basically it will be like this. Okay, I am writing down for those who could not understand. It is H2 upon G4 minus H1. So you take the LCM G4 and you will get H2 minus G4 H1 upon G4. This is it clear? Yes, it is parallel. Yes, very correct. So now you can replace it. Okay, so you will get like this. So ultimately your loop will, your block diagram, complex block diagram will look like. Now tell me, in which form it is? Tell me in which form it is. This first block, this one, okay, this block and this block, they are connected in which form? Parallel or feedback? Negative what? Negative feedback. Negative feedback. Most of the people are saying negative feedback. Anyone who's saying they are connected in parallel? No. Negative feedback. Now see what happens. This is feed forward signal like this, in this way, and this negative feedback is in this way. Okay, so this is a feedback signal. So you know the solution of this, G upon 1 plus GH. So G is here, this much, and H is here. So now you can get the using rule this. You have to solve it mathematically. Remaining is rest mathematics. If you commit the mistake in the mathematics, then no one can save you. But if you have a good mathematics in solving this, because you know this is G, this is your G is there, and this is your H is there. So it is G upon 1 plus GH for negative feedback. So substitute wherever G is there, this one, and wherever GH is there, this one and this one. And ultimately you will get this transfer function G1, G2, G3, G4 upon 1 plus G2, G3 H3 plus G3 G4 H4 plus G1 G2 G3 H2 minus G1 G2 G3 G4 H1. Okay, so you will get this much of the answer. Okay, any confusion so far up to this, so that we can move proceed to the fourth numerical. Yes. Those who are actively participating, they have no problem. But I can see there are 23 participants are there. Okay, starting from Akash, Soni, Alisha, Amit Paliwal, Chandrakant Tanwani, Eva Sharma, Harshita, Hirendra Singh Gyalowot, Hitesh Rathod, जगदीश बेवाल, काजर, कीर्ति, कृतिका, प्रणंजय, पार्थ, प्रवीण अहिर, सचिन सिंह, संजय प्रजापत, शीतल खटीक, श्रेयस बोरा, सुधांशु, सुरेंदर, तुषार एंड वैभव नागदा. एवरीबडी शुड बी एक्टिव एंड शुड टेक एक्टिवली पार्ट इन दिस अवर कन्वर्सेशन. देन ओनली वी कैन हैव अ गुड सक्सेसफुल ऑनलाइन क्लास. अदरवाइज इट इज जस्ट एन फॉर्मेलिटी. यू कैन सी आउट ऑफ 75 in the previous day 44 students has joined and now it has reduced to 24. This is a really again once again that just we have are having 8th class only, and either I am teaching in a poor way or you are not in a good learner. Only one thing can happen. Okay, so I don't know what is the problem. Now, those who could not understand, I am giving you that right comments in my videos also. That sir, I could not understand this. You can modify these things. Okay. You can put in this form. We can have this. Okay. I'm trying my best to deliver the things as if they were being delivered as in an offline class. So, no comment was there from your side. Probably you may be biased by some group or something. I don't know. But, I am trying my best to deliver a quality online education. Okay. And when the offline class will start, we will continue this and making another new concept called flip classroom. Okay. So I am keep on innovating the things, but it should be a two-way thing. It is not should be a one-way. Okay. So another question I am taking. Okay, so I think so this question is in front of you. Okay, so you can see that there is a blocks are there with the feedback function. Okay, so now you have to again find out YS over RS. So the what will be the question? Find out the overall transfer function of this block diagram. So you have to find out YS over RS. So now look towards this question. Okay, so what can be the first step from your side? Please write in the chat box how you can solve it. First of all, who is creating problem? Yes. Shift point A to B. A is a pickup point. So shifting pickup point from A behind a block G3. Okay, fine, good. So let us start. Okay, the same thing is there, which you have told many of people, you have told you that what you have to do. Okay, I have shifted it. In shifting, what I have to add an block with transfer function 1 upon G3, because I am shifting behind block G3. So it will 1 upon G3 has been added to the path where pickup point is there. So 1 upon G3 has been added. So now, what will be the next step? Can anybody tell me what can be the next step? I've already told you, try to shift pickup point on the output side and the summing point on the input side. So are you seeing any summing point creating disturbance? Yeah, definitely you can solve it. These two are connected in cascade. So it will become G2, G3. And also this G2, G3. Will be in feedback with H2, so negative feedback also, so it will become G2 G3 upon 1 plus G2 G3 H2. Okay, very correct. Okay, so let us move. But before this, let us make another modification. Okay, so what we will do, we will shift this summing point ahead of the block G1. Okay. So when you are moving and summing point ahead of a block, okay, what will be the answer? Can anybody tell me? Yes, Kirti Verma saying that block will be added with transfer function G. Everybody agrees? Okay, fine. Kirti Verma is correct. Okay, anybody? So your all rules should be on the tips. It is not that again you look towards to some checkup book or a textbook. It should be on the tips that when you are moving and some point behind or ahead of a block. So here you are shifting ahead of a block. So when you are shifting ahead of a block, what will happen? What will happen? So there is some mistake is there, okay, in the question, okay, so don't get confused. I am just rectifying it through annotation. In fact, you are shifting this point ahead of block this, so it should be what? It should be what? Can anybody can correct what should be there? It should be 1 upon G, yes, it should be 1 upon G. Kirti Verma, please correct yourself. It should be 1 upon G. Yes, it is 1 upon G, very correct. But what is the mistake here? Can anybody can tell me? Yeah, very correct. When are moving a summing point, it should be 1 upon G1. Very correct. Amit Paliwal is correct. Because I am moving ahead of this block. Okay, this block transfer function is G1, not G3. So by mistake, it has been written G3. It should be G1. So please do correct. Here also do correct. Because when I am shifting to this, then this this is being also affected and this is also being affected. So it will should be 1 upon G1 and 1 upon G1 to the both the side. So ultimately please make correction, it is 1 upon G1. Okay, so ultimately when you solve it, it will become like this. G2 G3 will be in cascade, okay, and it will be H1 upon G1. Please make correction, it is not G3, it is G1. So it will be looking like this. Okay, so your ultimately block diagram will look like this. Then you can solve it further. Okay, this is again a negative feedback is there. Okay, this is again a negative feedback. So when you solve it, negative feedback. Now see this block and this block, they are connected in. Please tell me in the chat box, they are connected in. They are connected in parallel. They are not in feedback group. They are connected in parallel. Very correct. So now you have to just add it and the resultant will be G4 upon 1 plus. There should be some mistake because the block should be 1 upon G1 instead of the G3. So I will send you the correct slide. So do make this correction, but don't get confused. Okay, we are moving ahead of a block, the summing point. So the transfer function will be added, will be put in that block diagram in the inverse form, 1 upon G1, not in the G3 it should be. Okay, so it is clear, I think so. Now another question is there. Okay, example 2 I have taken. Determine the effect of R and N on Y in the following diagram. Okay, so definitely, sir, how we can determine it, how we can understand it. It is also a question of block diagram reduction technique. You are not been directly asked that find out YS over RS, but you have been asked that now see what is the new thing you are seeing here. Can anybody can write in the chat box, look toward this question, what new things are you seeing in this block diagram in the example 2? What new things you are seeing? N, so N is what? N you are seeing, no doubt, a new word is there, N instead of R, and R and Y are already there, but N is there. But what is N? N is another input signal which is called noise. There are two inputs. Very good. There are two inputs are there. One is your so-called, what is one is there? One is your RS. This is another is noise. and a single output Y. Okay, so can this, because so far we have considered only MIMO system. Sorry, we have considered CISO system. Single input, single output system. But here we have multiple input and single output. MISO, MISO. So it is MISO is there. Okay, so can we proceed? How we can proceed? If we are asked, this question can be in this form also. Find out the overall transfer function of this system. Or find out the output YS of this given function. Can anybody can tell me? If I say find out YS, when this input is there, can we can find it? How we can find it? Find it. If you remember, now if you are not giving the answer, then I should reply. There are two inputs, no doubt is there. Now I will reply that you have to clear in the mind that I am defining transfer function for which type of system. Tell me in the chat box, a transfer function is defined for which type of system. Write down, transfer function is defined for which type of system, chat box. Should be active, not CISO, not CISO system. Oh. LTI means two port Akashoni. Yes, Akashoni has given very, yes, Kirti Verma has elaborately given the answer. Kirti Verma, Shiresh Bora is also giving correct answer. Very good, very good, very good, very good. Okay, Vaibhav Nagda has also given, yes, very correct. Vaibhav Nagda has also given correct answer. So 3% has given very correct answer. One has given correct answer. Akashoni has given correct answer. But Shreyash, Vaibhav, Kirti, they have given very correct answer. What about the rest? What about the rest people? Okay, Jagdish Meghwal has also given correct answer in short form, LTI. Very good. So without wasting time, I will say that the transfer function is defined for linear time invariant system. So linear word is there. So whenever linear system is there, okay, it is clearly indicating that we can apply the superposition theorem. We can apply superposition theorem. Is it clear or not? So whenever a linear system is there, it is very correct that we can apply superposition theorem. And superposition theorem is valid for more than one sources. If you remember superposition theorem, then you should remember that it is applicable for more than one source, one input, so more than one input. So here we are having two R and N, okay, one output YS. So we can easily find out, okay. So what we will do in superposition theorem, what we do? We keep one source and make all the other sources to be zero. So here also, we will first of all find out YS corresponding to RS and make NS is equal to 0. At that time, NS will become 0. And second time, what we will do? We will make R is equal to 0 and we will keep N is equal to as an input and find out YS. So ultimately, Y will be equal to nothing but YR plus YN. Okay. So because superposition theorem stated that two inputs are, they obey the law of additivity. So the same principle will be applied here if two inputs are there. Is it clear or not? So how thing concepts are there? These became the questions of the gate only. Okay. So I think so it is clear now that when two inputs are there and single input output is there, how to deal such type of question. The same thing I have explained you, that Y will be equal to Y1 plus Y2, where Y1 is nothing but the transfer function of when input R is there, and Y2 is the transfer function obtained when the input N is there. So if we set N is equal to 0, then we will get Y1. Clear? If we set R is equal to 0, then Y2 is obtained, and therefore Y2 is nothing but transfer function multiplied by the input N. Thus, the output is given like this. Is this clear or not? This is clear or not? If not, please write a question mark in the chat box. Please write question mark in the chat box. Yes, Jayesh Bora. He is very innocent student. He used to write everything, whether he understand or not. Or if he understand, he write clear things. Things are clear. If he could not understand, he say yes. The doubt is there. Very good. Okay. So you can see there are two inputs are there. And being a linear system, we can apply superposition theorem. Okay. So superposition theorem state that apply one input while make other input to be zero. So we will apply first of all R input and find out the transfer function. We will apply the R input and find out the transfer function. Let the transfer function is T1. Therefore, output Y1 is nothing but T1 multiplied by R. Okay. Then what we will do? We will make R is equal to zero and apply the input signal as N. Okay. Let the transfer function obtain is T2. So Y2 is nothing but transfer function multiplied by that input N. Okay. So, and we know that in a superposition theorem state that the resultant is nothing but the algebraic sum of all the responses caused due to the source acting alone. So this is the response obtained when R1 is acting. This is the response obtained when N is acting. So the total response will be Y1 plus Y2. Okay. Y1 obtained when N is equal to zero and Y2 obtained when R is equal to zero. So Suresh, I think so it is clear. If not, then please write it. Clear? Okay. So we have applied superposition theorem when there are two inputs are there. This is also a very good important question. So let us see the solution. Okay. So in the solution, okay, what will happen? What we do, first of all, we'll make N is equal to zero. First of all, we'll make N is equal to zero and also swap the summing point. Mind it. Side by side, let us say the first step N is equal to made zero, so N is not existing. Now we can swap the so-called the swap, because there is no in between these two summing point, nothing is present, no pickup point is there. Okay, so swap means we can interchange it. B will come in place of A and A will come in the place of A. So see how things will get modified. This was the question. Okay, this was the question. Okay, you just go through it. This was the question. Okay, now what we are doing that we are just okay, so we have just interchanged it. Again, look towards the original question. In the original question, this was the summing point. Okay, which was N has been made zero. Okay, so this will directly come here. And this is going like this. Okay. So I have shifted. This is come to this place. And sorry, this summing point has come to this place. And this has come to this place. See what change has been made. Okay. Is it clear? Now it is clear. Now see, by changing what happens, that what happens. See, when this has come to this place and this is shifted to this place, what happened? This is already was in this is already in what? Feedback form. This one. And what will be the transfer function of this? G2 upon 1 plus G2 H1. So I have already written it here. G2 upon 1 plus G2 H1. Now by swapping this signal, what happened? G2 upon 1 plus G2 H1 and G3, they are connected in which form? Please write in the chat box. G2 upon 1 plus G2 H1 and G3 are in which form? They are in? Suresh Bora, yes, given. Pranjay is given. The same guys out of 23. Akash Soni, yes, Sudhanshu, correct. Very correct. Vaibhav Nagda, correct. Chandrakant Tanwani has now replied. Amit Paliwal, correct. Alisha, correct. Hitesh Rathod, so yes, everybody has got this. These are connected in parallel. So I can write down what will be their resultant G2 upon 1 plus G2 H1 plus G3. Okay, it is very correct. Again, G1 will be in cascade. So G1 has been multiplied with the whole block. So it will become G1, G3, G1, G2 upon 1 plus G2, H1. I think so it is clear or not. Okay. Now see, look towards this there. Okay. This N is not there. So please forget about this N. Though I am writing again and again, but N has been made zero. So now see, this is coming like this and this is coming like this. So G4 and this block, consisting of G1, G3 plus G1 upon G2, 1 plus G2H2, they are connected in which form? Can anybody can tell me? Yes, write down in the chat box. This is a very important question. This block G1, G2, Pranjay has given right. Surendra Rajpro is wrong answer. Please write other people. I will not speak out the answer. Suresh Vora, wrong answer. Eva Sharma, wrong answer. Alisha, correct answer. Alisha Sharma has already given the answer to each and every person. So I need not have to wait for Hitesh Rathod. Now you are giving answer. Okay, so no problem. So they are connecting in positive feedback. Mind it now, forget about this plus sign because N is not existing, though it is written, okay? So forget about this. So signal is what happened? Signal is moving like this and going like this. Now this signal is moving forward direction. This is moving in the feedback in the reverse direction. So these are in connected in feedback. And now feedback is there with the positive sign. So it is not a negative feedback. It is a positive feedback. And what will be the transfer function of for a positive feedback? G upon 1 minus GH. So this is G and this is your H. So H is how much? It will be G4. So now you can. So it will look like this. Now he is making N is equal to 0. You need not have to worry. Sorry, there was some, there is some correction is there. N has been made 0. One mistake we have done. Please correct. I'm correcting myself. Because we have made N is equal to 0. And this G4 is picking signal from N. Please look towards this. Please correct yourself, okay, because I have not eliminated in the earlier, so that is why that confusion is created. So please look towards this, what I want to say, N has been made equal to 0 when RS is existing. So, and this G4 is picking signal from N. Since N is equal to 0, so G4 will become 0. So there's, because when output is nothing, 0, okay, what you are picking? You are picking 0, so this will get eliminated. So you have to eliminate it. A very important question, okay? It is not in positive feedback, okay? It is it will be removed. So when N is equal to 0, see, look towards, when N is equal to 0, look, everything is, it is not positive feedback, it is not in parallel, it is being removed. So we are left with this only G1, G3 plus G1 upon G2. And now see, a negative feedback is still existing. Can anybody can tell me that what is H in the remaining loop? Suresh Vora has written good answer. Sudhanshu, Kirti Verma, Jagdish Vela, correct. Yes, it is a unity feedback system where H is equal to 1. And therefore, when you solve it, you will get this much G1, G2. When you solve it, you will get this much Y1. So Y1 is nothing but this is the transfer function which we will obtain. Y1 multiply by G1 G2 plus G1 G3 plus this, okay, multiply by R, obtained when N is equal to 0 and only R was existing. So now come the second part of this solution, that is, now we will keep N and R is equal to 0. So now this is there. So you have to modify it somewhat. So when N is present, okay, because generally in your mind, the input side is generally on the left hand side and the output is on generally on the right hand side. Okay, so I have redrawn it. You do not have to confuse. R is that been made 0, and therefore now what is the main question. So I am going to the main question so that it, so this was the main question. Okay, so R has been made 0, Okay, so no input from this side. Okay, so what will happen? This will directly come to here, and only this is existing. Only n is existing while r has been made zero. So when you will, so again this is again g2 upon 1 plus g2 h1, it will become, okay, and what will happen? What will happen? Can anybody can tell me? So when r is being made zero, okay, then your loop will now look like this. See, n is coming, one for plus sign, another for plus sign, and in between the loop will get solved g1, g2, and this is the g4. Okay, so that's how it will look like. Okay, so now question arises, what to do? We'll break this summing point, okay, and individually put, because you can like in this way, you can put in this way also. Okay, so one is giving positive and another is giving a, so you can put like this form also with unity feedback, okay? And this on this side is the g4, which has already been included in it. Okay, so like this. Okay, so you will get these type of blocks. Now these two blocks are connected in cascade, so you will get y2 is this. Okay, y2 in this form, and ultimately according to the principle of superposition, y1 will be combined together so that we have y is equal to y1 plus y2, so we will get this. So this ends just for simplification purpose. Mind it, somebody has, why we break this point? Okay, just for simplification purpose, because what happens? What is happening? This signal is coming here, this signal is coming here and going to this block. It means this signal is going to this block also, and this signal is going to this block also. So just we are breaking this in order to get simplified it. So when I will simplify it, okay, the this block will be added to this also, and this block will be added to this also, and in this way the things get simplified. So when it gets simplified, on this side we will have g1, g3, g4 plus 1 plus g1, because on this side when I will put that, it will be form of, in full form of like this, and on this side it will be in the form of like this. So I think so. You go revise through all this. Tomorrow I will take more question. Okay, tomorrow I will take, yes, definitely algebraic sign is to be taken into a, one will be in parallel form and another will be in which form, you have to take into account this. Okay, the plus sign, if in the same direction, then it will be parallel, and when it will be minus sign, in this case you will see they are in feedback form. So you have to take into account their sign also. Yes, you have to put their sign also. And in that sign, you can see that one is in parallel form and another is in the feedback form. That have to be taken into account. So my basic advice is that you go through this, all this. Okay. And if you have any problem, please do write on the comment section so that I can take some more numericals related to it. And two more important rules have been left behind. Okay, so that we will take in the next class. So far the numericals we have done with the very simple rules, but there are two important rules. If there is a pickup point is there between a summing point or between two pickup point, a summing symbol is there, then how to deal with that becomes two important questions. Okay, so with that we will deal in the next class, but so far we have done with the simple six or seven rules. Okay, moving a summing point ahead and behind, moving a pickup point ahead and behind of a block, and we have taken some numerical, 4 to 5 numerical. So that's all for today, and if you have any problem related to any numericals, then please write down in the chat box, in the comment section of my video available on the YouTube. Okay, I will take into account all the questions. Thank you very much.